Welcome to the first video in our house build series. This one is documenting the earthworks and the very beginning of the whole journey. This is what we are working with, our beautiful bush block in Australia's southwest. As you can see, it is very dense bushland. We did not want to clear as much of it as we had to, but Australia has, well, at least WA, but I'm pretty sure it's Australia-wide, this is our driveway, by the way, has really strict bushfire regulations. So we had to clear pretty much all of our building envelope and only leave some grass trees, which are very, very old, and some mature trees. But everything else, unfortunately, had to go. Trust us, it was depressing and not something I was really happy about, but it's to mitigate the risk of bushfires coming through the area and destroying homes and accelerating the, you know, intensity of the fire, because we are living in a really high risk bushfire zone. Next, this is with everything cleared. It is very bare and barren, but we got to keep all of the grass trees. We were very, very adamant about that because they are very, very special and take a lot of time to grow. So this was very exciting because it was the first time that anything had really changed on our block. We had been visiting for about 6 months up until this point and nothing was any different. So this was like kind of the commencement of our house being built, which is really exciting. Reese and I's first house. We have owned a home before. This is the first time we've built a house. So it's all very exciting. Okay, we're about to go into the next phase, which is the pad. No, this isn't the pad. This is the sand pad. So as you can see, the land was cut into at the left of the screen. You can kind of see that drop off. Our block is sloped. This is our new driveway with the pebbles on top so that the trucks can get up. And this is a little before and after just so you can get an idea of like your bearings and where you are. And look at this stunning view, the grass trees. This was a problem. That kind of cliff was way too steep. And if it rained, it would basically go straight into our house. So you'll soon see that we did some work to mitigate that. Now we have the outline of the house. Oh wait, no, that was the same as the last video. It's just person's view. Person view? What's the word? I don't know what the word is, but I'm going to keep going. we have the footings and everything for our cement pad. And our water tank is in. Woo! Beautiful color. Stoked. We do rely solely on that water tank for our water. Many people have asked about that. Now we've got the barriers around the pad so that the cement can be poured, which is what is happening right now. Gosh, so exciting. That's how it's looking. Now the next stages are going to be kind of taking you around the block and showing you the terracing. So now you can see that that big slope has started to be cut into. These are all the beautiful limestone boulders from the block that have been excavated. Little snits who blends into the sand. So you can see that we're kind of terracing it into a few steps so that we can plant stuff on here and it's less of a risk if it rains and having all the crap basically flow into the bottom of the house, because instead of building on stilts, we chose to cut into the block for a few reasons. We'll go into that another day. Unfortunately, the grass trees were covered with sand. The guys didn't really ask us about this, the earthworks guys, so we had to fix this afterwards. We just didn't want the grass trees to die, even though some of our other trees are also buried, but I don't know. You got to pick your battles. So yes, this is the terracing. It's not finished, but it's almost ready. The earthworks guys were great. They kept the topsoil aside so that we could put it back over the terraces and then hope that some seeds would germinate. That's Reese's shed pad. This is basically, I think this is done. So as you can see, that dark brown soil has now been laid over that top hill, which means that, yeah, eventually, hopefully we'll get some seeds germinating, because that's where all the seeds usually are, in that top soil. So that was a lovely idea on their behalf. And then here we'll eventually put some grass and lots of native ground covers and plants and that kind of thing. Here is where our deck will be and our little like veranda thing. So we come back and what's this, Reese? Pest treatment, you think? thinks. He was his loving life, as always. And then, yeah, we just got the windows and doors, which is exciting. We've been told that bricks are coming in a week or two, and then he'll be laying them in 3 or 4 weeks. No, sorry, it'll take him 3 or 4 weeks to lay, but he should be laying in a couple of weeks, which is crazy. A lot sooner than we thought it would. Reese is such a clever cookie. It was a bit tough this morning trying to figure out how to use the little mini digger thing, but he has gotten the hang of it and is zipping around. These grass trees were, I feel like, at least a meter and a half deep, and he's excavating them. What a legend. He's just literally zipping, zooming, and all the sand is behind the water tank now. Look at him go. Wow, so satisfying. In the morning we were like, it was a waste of money, we shouldn't have like hired this thing just because it wasn't doing enough, but then we actually figured out how to use it, and worth every penny. Gloomy day today. Progress looking so much better. Reese has done an awesome job excavating these bad boys. It's raining. Not really any way to avoid this. We'll figure it out, but it's gonna have to stay like that, you know, have that really crisp edge. Otherwise we'd have to push it back and slope it back, and then we'd lose space on top. So we'll figure that out another day, but so far, so good. We will slope this out with the rakes another day. I said to Reese when we were driving here, I can't wait for freezing cold winter in this house. We'll have a fireplace. The house is going to be like, you know, at least in this area, a little bit sunken. So it's going to feel like, you know, a little cozy bunker. And then you got these beautiful views. And it just smells so fresh. The smell of rain in the bush. That's what it smells like. Shed pad is down. We've got bricks. Not very many, but we're thinking that because we have so many windows, we actually don't have as many solid walls, so perhaps this is all we actually need, and it must be because they said that they're done prepping the block now, so very strange, but we shall see. So that is the first installment. Thank you for watching. So exciting. For any videos in the future, I will likely speak to my phone when I'm recording so that I won't need to do a voiceover. But of course, if you want to stay up to date as everything's happening, just follow Loz Curtis Home, which is the Instagram account you've seen on the screen the whole time, and you'll be, yeah, kept up to date. Everything that I've shared so far has been kept in highlights on my profile, so you can also check those out. And yeah, hope you enjoyed. Stay tuned. The best is yet to come.